Hello viewers, today we talk about there's too much gold in the universe. No one knows where it came from. Sometimes it's raining gold across the universe but no one knows what it is. Here's the problem, gold is an element which means you cannot make it through ordinary chemical reactions. Thought alchemists tried for centuries to make this sparkle metal, you have to bind 79 protons and 118 neutrons together to form a single atomic nucleus. A new study has found the most commonly theorized origin of gold. Collisions between neutron stars cannot explain gold's abundance either. So where's the gold coming from? There are some other possibilities, including supernovas so intense they turn a star inside out. Unfortunately, even such strange phenomena cannot explain how blind out the local universe is. The new study finds neutron star collisions build gold up, briefly smashing protons and neutrons together into atomic nuclei, then spewing those newly bound half nuclei across space. Regular supernovas cannot explain the universe gold because stars massive enough to fuse gold before they die, which are rare, become black holes when they explode, said Chiaki Kobayashi, an astrophysicist at the University of Hertfordshire in the United Kingdom and lead author of the new study. And in a regular supernova, that gold gets sucked into the black hole. So what about those other star flipping supernovas? This type of star explosions, a so-called Mankato rotational supernova, is a very rare supernova spinning very fast, Kobayashi told Life Science. During a magneto-rotational supernova, a dying star spins too fast and is wrecked by such strong magnetic fields that it turns itself inside out as it explodes. As it dies, the star shoots white hot jets of matter into space. And because the star has been turned inside out, its jets are chock full of gold nuclei. Stars that fuse gold at all are rare. Stars that fuse gold then spew it into space like this are even rare. But even neutron star plus magneto rotational supernovas together cannot explain Earth bonanza of gold, Kobayashi and her colleagues found. There's two stages to this question, she said. Number one is neutron star megas are not enough. Number two, even with the sanctified source, we still cannot explain the observed amount of gold. Past studies were right that neutron star collisions release a shower of gold, she said, but it's certainly not very common. Scientists have seen it happen only once. Even rough estimates show they don't collide nearly often enough to have produced all the gold found in the solar system, Kobayashi and her co-authors found. This paper is not the first to suggest that neutron star collisions are insufficient to explain the abundance of gold, said Lon Roeder, an astrophysicist at the University of Michigan, who hunts traces of rare elements in distant stars. But Kobayashi and her colleagues' new paper, published September 15 in the Astrophysical Journal, has one big advantage. It's extremely thorough, Roeder said. The researcher poured over a mountain of data and plugged it into robust models of how the galaxy evolves to produce new chemicals. The paper contains references to 341 other publications, which is about three times as many references as typical paper in the Astrophysical Journal these days, Roeder told Life Science. Pulling all that data together in a useful way, he said, amounts to be a Herculean effort. Using this approach, the authors were able to explain the formation of atoms as light as carbon 12, 6 protons and 6 neutrons, and as heaven is as uranium 238, 92 protons and 146 neutrons. That's an impressive range, Roeder said, covering elements that are usually ignored in these types of studies. Mostly the math worked out. Neutron star collisions, for example, produce strontium in their model that matches observation of strontium strontium in space after the one neutron star collision scientists have directly observed. Magneto-rotational supernovas did explain the presence of europium in their models and other atoms that has proved tricky to explain in the past, but gold remains an enigma. Sometimes out there that scientists don't know about must be making gold, Kobayashi said. Or it's possible neutron star collisions make way more gold than existing models suggest. In either case, astrophysicists still have a lot of work to do before they can explain where all the fancy bling came from. So that's enough for this video. Please subscribe my channel and press bell icons for more updating videos. Thank you.